Morning students, welcome to the statistics class. As you all know, we have been doing with index number problems. In the previous class I have done with 1 mark, 2 marks problems, and now we go and solve the big one, weighted aggregative index number problems. Okay, this is the problem which may come across for 10 marks, wherein in this problem we need to solve all the weighted aggregative index numbers. So the following question, which is on the screen, is all about that. Okay, very clearly, just observe it. So what we see, this is very clearly that compute last year's Pasci's index number, Marshall Edgeworth index number. You can see that, right? Compute last year's Pasci's, Marshall Edgeworth's, Dobish, Pauli's and Fisher's index number for 2000 from the following data, and the data is very clear here. Okay, so they have five items here. 1995 is termed to be as base year, 2000 is termed to be as a current year. 1995 price, 1995 quantity, 2000 price, 2000 quantity, like that they have given to our students. So what we need to do is we need to remember the formula correctly and then do it. Okay, so now understand students, for this problem, right, 4 important terms are used all the time. 4 important terms are used. Okay, so what are those 4 terms? We will crop this problem and then we will solve this correctly so that we can understand what are the things that we are supposed to do it. Okay, this is what we have it, students, here, right? This is the problem that we have it. Compute last year's Pasci's, Marshall Edgeworth, Dobish, Pauli and Fisher's index number for 2000 from the following data. Is that clear? Right. Now when it comes to this, students, 4 important terms are required to solve this problem. Okay, 4 important terms are required to solve this problem. What are those 4 terms? Number one is P1Q0, students. This is the first term for all the items that you have to find out. The second one is P0Q0, students. Okay, this is the second one that we need to find out. The third one is P1Q1. We have to find out P1Q1. And the fourth one is P0Q1, students. These are the 4 columns or the 4 values that we have to find out. One, P1Q0, number 2, P0Q0, number 3, P1Q1, number 4, P0Q1. Is that okay? Now let's identify what are these. Price in the base year, that is 1995, is termed to be as P0, students. Quantity of 1995 is termed to be as Q0. Price in 2000 is termed to be as P1. Quantity in 2000 is termed to be as Q1. Clear? So when we have this, it's very easy for us to identify and solve the problem. So now P1Q0, that is 10 into 50. Okay, it's how much? 500. Then 2 into 100, it is 200. Then 6 into 60, it is how much? 360. Then 12 into 30, it is how much? 12 into 30, it is how much? 360. Okay, then 12 into 40, it is how much? 480. Likewise, next one, P0Q0, 6 into 50, memory plus, it is 300. two into 100 it is 200. 4 into 60, it is 240. 10 into 30, it is 300. 8 into 40, it is 320. P1, Q1, 10 into 50, 6, it is 560. 2 into 120, it is 240. 6 into 60, it is 360. 12 into 24 is 288. 12 into 36 is 432. 0 Q1. Next is P0 Q1. 6 into 56, it is 336. 2 into 120, it is 240. 4 into 60, it is also 240. 10 into 24, it is 240. And 8 into 36 is 288. So when we add these students, so you'll be getting what 12 plus 8 is 20 to carry forward. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 19, 1900. That is 300 plus 200 plus 240 plus 300 plus 320 is equal to 1360. 560 plus 240 plus 360 plus 288 plus 432 is 1880. 336 plus 240 plus 240. 336 plus 240 plus 240 plus 240 plus 288 is 1344. This is what, student, this is summation P1 Q0. This is summation P0 Q0. This is summation P1 Q1. This is summation P0 Q1. Okay, so now these are the terms that we require, students, and after finding out these terms, we start solving the problems for last pair students. For the last pair's index number P01L is equal to summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 into 100, students. Summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 into 100. Summation P1 Q0 is 1900 divided by summation P0 Q0 is 1360 into 100. 1900 divided by 1360 divided by into 100. 1900 divided by 1360 into 100 is 139.70% students. This is Laspierre's index number. Then we have Pasci's index number. Pasci's index number, that is summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1 into 100. Summation P1Q1 is 1880 divided by 1344 is equal to 139.88%. This is Pasci's index number, students. So when we have these two terms, then it's easy for us to solve other terms also, other weighted aggregative index number like Marshall-Edgeworth index number, Daubish-Bolle index number, Fisher's index number. We can do it, students. Okay, just observe it carefully. I'm erasing these two, students. I'll write this as here P01L is 139.70. And P01P is 139.88. Okay, so we will take these two terms and try to solve the problems, especially these Dobish-Bowley and Fisher's index number students. It's very easy for us to do, as we have learnt them using those 2 marks problems, how to solve those two terms. Okay, so this is a very simple one. This is a very simple problem, students. So don't get confused with this. Just follow this. So I'll do this first, Dobish-Bowley, and then Fisher's index number, and later I will solve Marshall-Edgeworth index number. So Dobish-Bowley index number is P01L plus P01P divided by 2. That is 139.70 plus 139.88 divided by 2. 139.70 plus 139.88 is 139.75% students. This is Dobish-Bowley index number. So when it comes to Fisher's index number, it is root of P01L into P01P. That is, P01L is root of 139.70 into 139.88 root of this 139.7 into 139.8 is 19,530.06 students. The root of this is 139.74% students. This is Dobish-Bowley and this is Fisher's index number students. Hardly you will find any difference in them. Okay, so then we will solve the last one, that is the Marshall-Edgeworth index number, using these terms. So Marshall-Edgeworth index number can be done right in 2 ways, students. Okay, but simplification already we have done, so we will solve that using this simplified form itself. So what is the formula for this Marshall-Edgeworth index number, students? What is the formula? Can you remember? If you remember, please tell me. Okay, what is the formula? Yes, I can hear you. Marshall-Edgeworth index number formula is sum of P1Q0 plus summation P0, P1Q1, okay, divided by summation P0Q0 plus summation P0Q1. This into 100, this whole numerator 1, denominator 1. Summation P1Q0 is 1900 plus summation P1Q1 is 1880 divided by summation P0Q0 is 1360 plus summation P0Q1 is 1344 into 100. So 1900 plus 1880 is 3780 divided by 1360 plus 1344, you get as 2704 students into 100. I'll continue this here, this side. It is 3780 divided by 2704 divided by 100 is 139.73%. So this is Marshall-Edgeworth index number. This is how we solve this problem, students. This is a 10 marks question. Please watch this video once again, right from the beginning. Anywhere you have any doubts, you can ask me, then I will explain this to you in detail. Okay, thank you very much.